I promise, guys, no jokes about girlfriends, none of that stuff. Me and Victoria are in a committed relationship with each other, and it's real.
The best face massage for glowing skin. Hello, my name is Victoria. Welcome to my channel. It's a pleasure to have you here with me. Today I wanted to film what I do.
Hello, my name is Frank. Welcome to my channel. It's a pleasure to have you here. I just love it.
In a day and day in a life, we're kind of combined. Now it's a super long intro. Let's jump straight to the video. For breakfast, I decided to make a smoothie bowl. I have been obsessed with them lately. They're just so quick and easy, and you can pack as much goodness as you like. Here, I added frozen zucchini, frozen banana. You won't taste frozen zucchini. It just adds really nice and creamy texture, and you're adding a veggie into your meal.
This is why I like Victoria so much. Her vegan knowledge is like top notch. She's doing things no other vegans are doing. Adding frozen zucchini to a smoothie for texture. Have you seen anyone else do that? It's her big ass Russian brain. Maybe she needs to put, what does she put, CBD oil in there? Maybe that's to calm herself down after the sugar rush. Who knows?
Which is always a positive, and it will fill you up. It will give you so much energy. This smoothie is super high in antioxidants. I used as well chia seeds and coconut for healthy fats, as well as coconut yogurt, so it will keep you fuller for longer, and it's turned out to be so creamy, delicious.
That looks amazing. And look, no BS like omega-6 nuts. Like Victoria knows coconut is where it's at.
With a sweet taste of blueberries. It was so good.
It
And I
looks
love
good.
to add crunchy toppings as well. Just to add some texture, it's one of my favorite breakfasts for sure. And while I eat my breakfast, I usually check the messages from my friends, reply to everyone, reply to comments, and just see what.
See, a lot of these vegan girls, they have like really big hands and they're not that feminine, but Victoria is like a good mix in between.
Have been happening, and what did I miss while I was sleeping? As well, every morning I try to do a little bit of self-care ritual because I just find the day just goes so much smoother if I
Me
dedicate this
too.
time in the morning for my well-being
Love
and
meditating.
for looking good, for feeling good. So I really love to incorporate a good face massage every morning, and I'll show you how to do it. Super easy. You can have a gua sha tool, but honestly, you just need your hands. You need a good oil.
I
You
really think she's
can
a robot.
feel and you can look so much better if you can do it on a daily basis. I use pineapple oil and rich with aloe vera, and it just works really well with my skin, and I just put it on both sides of my.
Look, her voice sounds like a robot. Her face actually looks like a robot. Like, if you were gonna make a female Russian robot, this is what it would look like. Like, this is definitely what it would look like.
Now I need to get some work done, so I will see you a little bit later.
Victoria, what type of work are you doing?
Simple technique, how you can deposit face if you wake up really puffy, and this works like a miracle. It's fast, it's really effective, and it's so simple. Massage your face against gravity. It's really fun. Just don't do it for too long. During the summer, I never can get enough of watermelons, so I have a good turkey shop nearby and want to go and get one as a snack. I guess they have the biggest, juiciest watermelons, but they're about 10 kilos heavy, each one of them. So it's a challenge to carry them, but it's just so worth it, and it's the most refreshing summer snack for me. What is your favorite fruit? So much for summer in London. It was so hot in the apartment. I'm definitely not dressed for this weather. It's raining. I got one. Hopefully it's gonna taste good because it's freaking heavy. It's so good. It's so sweet.
Is there anything more unrealistic than a Russian girl eating a watermelon?
cannot deal without watermelon during summer. So good. So good.
For lunch, I had a big salad with lentils that I cooked myself. I love to cook them from scratch because I cannot.
She should open up a restaurant. She should open up a restaurant. I like, Victoria, I will invest. Come to New York, open up one of these BS vegan restaurants, and we'll do it together.
Lots of spices and make them super flavorful. Here I added lots of greens, raw veggies, roasted peppers, my cooked lentils, good dollop of hummus, rooibos, drizzled everything with tahini, sprinkled omega-rich seeds.
You know, so far the day wasn't too bad. You know, we had a bunch of fruit for breakfast, had the watermelon, so not too much of an anti-nutrient concern there, just getting some caloric energy. Might be some pesticide agrochemical concerns, but with this meal, and we have a lot of seeds, we have a lot of omega-6 fatty acids, we have the grains, there's a lot more inflammation present here. I mean, she's no healthy Russian girl, apparently she's dealing with it just fine, but definitely noticing the lack of animal nutrition and really just caloric energy in general. This isn't that calorically dense, despite the bread and the hummus.
And it was absolutely delicious. For my sweet treat, I made mandel dates stuffed with peanut butter and sprinkled with coconut. If you never tried this combo, you seriously have to. It is heaven. I used crunchy peanut butter as a mandel date. They were so soft and squishy. They taste like a candy, and you don't need to add any sugar in your life to feel complete.
All right, boys, right now, go to paypal.com/franktofano and donate as much money as you can so we can sponsor Victoria to come over to New York and cook for me, because this stuff looks so good. I will go vegan for a day if Victoria spends the day with me, partially because she's cooking for me, partially because of other reasons, but let's make it happen, boys.
Always have them as a treat because they're just so delicious, and when you stuff them with nut butter, it's just much more balanced snack. It won't cause you sugar crash 2 seconds after because of the healthy fats, and healthy fats are so important for glowing skin. I seriously love this combo.
Well, I mean, look, peanut butter isn't exactly healthy fats. It's a bunch of mycotoxins, anti-nutrients. So Victoria, maybe we can improve a little bit with some macadamia nut butter.
So much, and I just snacked on them while I was working on the computer editing. It was so delicious, and yeah, if you never tried it, you have to.
I decided to go for a walk as well. I needed to get some groceries, so I wanted to walk to Planet Organic for the first time since lockdown. I haven't been in that supermarket for almost 2 months, and I really like it. Probably my favorite section in the supermarket are all these plant-based yogurts and cheeses made from everything, literally everything except the
Has favorite. Her voice gotten deeper as the video has gone on?
Wasn't going to buy beauty products, but it's 20% off my favorite toner.
Find them fascinating. Okay.
For dinner, I decided to make mushroom stroganoff. Growing up in Russia, my mom used to make beef stroganoff quite a lot, and I used to really.
I'm sure she used to make beef stroganoff. That's why you're so pretty and tall, because you ate a lot of beef.
I like it because of the creamy sauce. I never was too much into meat. This way, it was very easy.
Okay, yeah. You liked it because of the creamy sauce, not because of the meat, of course. Of course. Of course, a vegan would never crave meat.
For me to become a vegetarian in the first place, but this is a different story. Back to the recipe. I just wanted to make something hearty, something comforting, because it started to rain, it was gray, and I wanted something super creamy and super delicious. I started by sauteing onion and garlic in olive oil till translucent and fragrant. Then I added dry thyme and cooked it for about a minute longer till I really started to smell the spice.
You know, I think we should get Victoria Ciro versus Sofia Esperanza cook-off. That would be, you know, I would be okay if I died that night.
followed by my chopped chestnut mushrooms. You can use any mushrooms that you like, it's completely up to you. I added a good pinch of salt and black pepper as well, followed by veggie stock. Then I added tahini and stirred everything together so it's nicely combined. Allowed it to cook for about 5 minutes, and lastly I poured my unsweetened almond.
Victoria, I've been a fan of the recipe so far, but putting tahini, sesame paste, and stroganoff is definitely a questionable judgment call.
Milk sprinkled nutritional yeast, sage salt for seasonings, and just cooked it for 3-4 minutes longer till it thickens slightly. And yeah, good to go. It's ready. It's warm, comforting, delicious. Everything that you want from a good dinner.
I think that is a little bit of a strange angle, but my camera is balancing on top of two pillows because I'm too lazy now to go downstairs to get a tripod and to set everything up properly, so excuse me while I'm having my tea and a piece of dark chocolate, which is heaven. This one
hemp seed
heart, and it's absolutely delicious. Now I need to go downstairs and do my evening skincare routine, which is very similar to morning, except I like to exfoliate and use any acids if I do use them on that day, on the evening. And yeah, I'm about to go to sleep to read my book, and that completes this day.
We've seen vegan day of eatings that are much worse than this, and what really makes them bad is a really high amount of processed foods and grains, soy, tofu, as well as the high omega-6 tahini. When she did add omega-6, she didn't add that much, and she didn't use any like artificial processed garbage nonsense. And it's kind of sad that at best a vegan diet is caloric energy, and if you go organic and buy really high quality produce, you can remove some of the pollutant concerns, but it's really only a matter of time until you start degenerating physically and mentally and start staring at squirrels in the park when you follow a vegan diet. So thank you guys for joining me today. If you could please like the video, drop me a comment down below, and above all, please share the video on social media if you can. If you guys do want to support me further, you know how to do so down in the description. Thanks again for joining me, guys. I'll see you for tomorrow's video.